teremos agora uma escola técnica no Canadá, é a ITD Canada. Então, para conversar um pouco sobre a ITD, eu vou chamar o Sohail e o Jamak. Hello. Hi, how are you guys doing?
Hi, Luca. We're fine. It's almost early in the morning on a Saturday in Vancouver, so we're just getting ready to do our day. But nice to
Great,
be here.
perfect. Great way to start the day. So if you don't mind, I'm just going to introduce the presentation and a bit about ITD in Portuguese for a minute, and then
Sure.
I'm going to pass the voice to you. Então a ITD, ela é uma escola técnica no Canadá. E nessa sessão o Sohail e o Jamak vão falar um pouco sobre o que é ter um diploma, o que é ser um profissional técnico no Canadá. E enfim, eu acho que vocês podem inferir mais sobre a apresentação ouvindo eles. Então, so I'm just gonna ask you to tell a bit about yourself and ITD, and yeah. Thank you
Sure.
for coming and please be welcome.
Not a problem. We're actually very pleased to be here because we believe that we can give good information to people, to your clients there. We didn't want to make it all about our school. We just wanted to give some information about the tech climate in Canada and specifically in BC and even in Vancouver. My name is Sohail Gorgi. I am an immigrant. I have been in Canada for 26 years. And when I came to Canada, I was a young person, just like you are, Luca. I was 27 when I moved to Canada, and I already had a bachelor's degree in computer science. When I moved to Canada, I actually went back to school. I got a master's and a PhD in computer science. My bachelor's was in computer hardware. My master's and PhD is in computer communication. So all my professional life, I had only one job. I was a computer scientist. And I mean, like, yes, I am an educator right now. I am the president and the founder of ITD Canada. I have founded ITD Canada in 1998, so we're effectively 23 years old. And if you actually look into the entire history of Canada, the Canada is only 114 years old. So we are like quite old when it comes to the history of Canada. Like we've been operating for at least quarter of the life of Canada or even more. So let me just tell you a little bit about myself. Like I told you, I am a computer scientist. I have founded and operated and is still operating a lot of tech companies. Our bread and butter is tech, and the college that I founded as well, for like years, it was only offering computer science programs. With a variation, like with me spending a lot of time in the university, it just taught me what is done right, in my opinion, and what is not done right, in my opinion, in a university environment. So I decided to make something that is very much more practical rather than being a theoretical kind of thing. So as a result, starting my life in Canada, I founded a school, and like 23 years later, I am extremely happy with the outcome. Because I have direct connection in the industry. I actually have a few tech companies and myself, and then almost everybody in Vancouver who's working in tech, they actually know about us, know about me in person. And like, a lot of people that I went to school 25 years ago, they are now managers of big tech companies. So I have like re really good connections in the tech industry. And I exactly know what is happening in the market, what is required from people to know. And that's how we're actually building our programs. We're building our programs based on the market needs. We're just not like a university. Like normally when you're going to universities, they are government funded. They get the money from somewhere and they're just basically teaching everything and anything. What we do here is that we know the tech culture in Vancouver and BC. We actually acquire the government data of what is needed in the next 10 years. And then we basically create our programs around that. So we have like data analysts, data scientists that they take a look at the data that we get. And basically we figure out what is needed in the workforce. And as opposed of that, like in parallel with that, we just need to know what is it required for us to create a person who can fulfill the responsibilities in the workforce, and then we build a program. So in general, I am a veteran IT. I have been working in an IT environment for at least 26 years in Canada. Before that, I have like 6 or 7 years experience in my home country. It's fair to say that ever since I was 15 years old, I never touched anything else but computers. And I've been a professional. That's the only job I ever held. If I wasn't sitting in front of computers, creating programs and being innovative, I was actually teaching it. So I was trying to find innovative teaching methods to teach people. The cool thing is that every 10 years of my life, my interest kind of like got diverted. Like when I was a teenager, and during my 20s, I was a tech savvy. I was in love with tech stuff. Then I got in love with education, then business, then law. And then, you know, like every 10 years, I acquired another degree after another degree after another degree. However, like right now at the age of 52, I just look back. I think I accomplished whatever I wanted to accomplish. One of the things that I would like to say is that Jean-Marc, who is like my brother, my best friend, and also the vice president of the college, is actually the product of ITD Canada. So I'll just pass it to Jean-Marc to kind of like take it on and speak a little bit about his experience.
Thanks, Sohail. Luca, thank you very much for being here, for the introduction. I wish I could speak Portuguese. All I know is to the bane. That's all I can say. But, you know, I promise we'll work on that. Thank you, Sohail. So yeah, as he said, you know, I'll give you a little bit of background about myself as well and how I got introduced to Sohail. I'm also an immigrant, moved to Canada about a little over 30 years ago when I was 14 years old, went to high school in North Vancouver, went to UBC, which is one of the bigger universities here. I got a degree in genetics and a degree in education. And like many, many young adults, I found that I can't make money with my degrees. So I started looking around, trying to figure out what can I do. And I don't know if you guys are old enough to remember, but around year 2000, there was the dot-com boom. People were making so much money in the US, in the Silicon Valley. And I figured, you know what, I'll give it a shot. I'll go do computers. So that's when somebody introduced me to Sohail, who was teaching at that point. I went to school and then I moved. After I learned some stuff, I moved to California, lived in Silicon Valley for 15 years and worked in a bunch of high-tech companies. Then I decided to come back to Vancouver because I had two kids and I wanted them to be around my parents and grow. But that's enough about us. What I want, you know, you're sitting here spending your time listening to us. What's in it for you? Why are you listening to us? What is this going to do for you? You're young individuals, either still in school or just getting out of school. And if you're interested in the tech industry, I think this short presentation and then just being introduced to Sohail and I might change your life as you move forward. Because the tech industry is a very, very booming industry right now around the world, not just in Canada, but because of the proximity that British Columbia and Vancouver by extension has to California, which where all of these tech companies are, and to Washington State in United States, where you have Microsoft and various other big companies like Amazon, for example, the opportunities for technology working in tech in big companies is on the rise. It's been rising for many, many years, and now it continues to rise. There's a huge demand for technology jobs in Vancouver, in BC as a whole, and it keeps on increasing. We don't have enough people that can do the tech work. The issue that you come across is that it takes a long time to go to university and to get the degrees that are necessary to be able to know what you need to do to go to do the work. as Sohail was alluding to earlier, the programs that we've put together in ITD are very special in the sense that the college as a whole is very special, because when you walk through the doors, the very first thing you hear from us is, listen, you're gonna get ready over the next 1 year to go get a job. That's it. That's our entire focus. And if you want to be in the tech sector, that's all we do with you. We work on the tools that you need. We, as he said, we talk to industry experts to figure out what exactly do you need. When you go sit at a computer at a work interview, or when you do get a job and you want to work, all the stuff you learn as a computer engineer, for example, over 4 years, there is probably 20% of it that's useful. We focus on that 20% and we just drop everything else. That's how we can manage to teach you in 11 months, because our programs are 4 terms. Each term is 3 months long and you get a week in between. You get a week off in between. So in total, it's about 11 months. You come to school for 11 months. And then guess what? This is the really cool part, is we help you use the connections that I have and Sohail has to get a co-op position. This co-op position is a paid position. So basically for your entire second year, you go to work. You go to work at a tech company or in a tech position so that you become familiar with the way Canadian business works and the way tech works specifically. So with that, we've basically catered everything so that even if you haven't touched a computer, which is impossible, but even if you haven't touched a computer in your life, you come to ITD in a span of 11 months, so a span of 1 year, but 11 months academic, we get you to a position where you can walk into a junior position and go make money. And then that's all it's about, right? So some of you listening, and because we have a lot of students that have aspirations to live in Canada, right? So if you feel like you want to come to Canada and live there, or if you just come there to study, but after staying in Vancouver for 1 year and then at a college and then working for another year, you know, you think, this is a cool place, I like to live here, then there are various immigration pathways that are specially in place for people who are in technology. Now, you know, this presentation obviously is about technology, so we're focusing on that. The focus isn't ITD. We're trying to get you to understand how the tech market works and what you can do. So I want to turn it back over to Sohail, because he's more familiar with the immigration pathways, so that he can walk you through just a few, you know, like just a couple of different things that are hot right now that are basically every single student that we've had from Brazil or anywhere else in the world that's gone through our tech program and wanted to stay in Canada is here working, making very good money. So Sohail, if you can spend a few minutes and talk about Tech Pilot and other programs, that'd be awesome.
Absolutely, absolutely. But I'd like to start to say the major difference between a vocational college like us and a university. It has to be very clear, because then we're just gonna start focusing on the job market and what is the climate in Vancouver. Everybody knows, and it's very ironic for it to come out of somebody who spent half of his life in universities. I spent at least 10 to 12 years in university to realize that I'm just working toward a degree. Like, you go to university to just get a degree. The goal is the paper that you're having. And the paper comes with a prestige, but not necessarily working knowledge. I experienced it firsthand. I just finished my bachelor's degree. I came out and I'm like, I don't know anything. It took me 2 years to spend at my military service to become a honed engineer. I didn't really learn a lot at the university. Yes, I learned a lot of math. I am capable of doing numerical calculations of differential equations. I'm doing calculus. I'm doing, you know, high degree equalities or whatever, but it never helped me in my day-to-day work. I spent about 300 credits, maybe even more, to just make it to the PhD. And honestly, I'm not even using more than 20 of them right now. So the rest of it is kind of like the fluff that is connected to the core stem of knowledge base that you need to have. I started learning about this soon after I started my master's degree. I was going through courses that they were absolutely unrelated to whatever that I wanted to do. But yet still, because the goal was that piece of paper that has a title on it, I just wanted to go. It was at that time that it hit me that, you know what, I can kind of get rid of all the fluff, give people whatever they require based on whatever is needed on the job market. Let me portray the job market of tech here. Even at the time that I came here, there were more jobs than people. It's very logical to think of Canada like that. Why does Canada or any other immigrant friendly country, why do they want to bring people from other countries? The only reason is that the job is there, the people are not there. And I'm not talking about people, yes, Canada does have homeless people. We do have people that they're not working. There are all of that. But the number of people that they're qualified enough to get a job is not enough. That's why we're actually creating immigration programs to bring people from overseas. And I think right now I'm a Canadian, but in general, I think government of Canada has been extremely smart creating a program that all geniuses in the entire world, they end up in Canada. Because the working environment and the abilities and it's just so much. The sky is the limit. I experienced it myself. I probably, if I had stayed in my home country, I wouldn't have been at the place that I am. But Canada will let you get to wherever you deserve. How? Well, Canada is one of the best countries when it comes to economy. We are like a part of a G8 summit where like Canada is like one of the richest countries or one of the 8 most richest countries in the world. We're so advanced in science, in commodities. So Canada is an advanced country. Everybody agrees with that. Canada is probably, I don't know exactly, but Canada is probably 10 times bigger than Brazil. If not 10, I am sure it is 5 times bigger than Brazil. Brazil has 230 million people in it. Canada has only 30 million people in it, right? Out of the 30, only 10 million can work. Out of the 10 million, there is only 5 million that they actually acquired the skills that are needed to get the job done. So what is our solution? We have to bring people from overseas. But the way that the government of Canada is doing, it's like at first it was just we want, I mean like 30, 40 years ago, it's like we want people in general. But now they're very focused, they're razor sharp focused on getting people that they're already skilled or they get their skills really fast in Canada. So what do they do? There is like multiple different immigration programs available here. I am not an immigration consultant, I'm not trying to play one, but I've been dealing with immigration law for the past 20 some odd years. There is 3-4 ways to get in Canada in general, and there is like multiple branches. If I want to categorize them, probably there is 100 different ways to make it to Canada. One of which that everybody knows about is called Federal Skilled Worker. This is for young individuals whose English are good, they have background and experience, and they have a degree, okay? But that is very, very slim. The Federal Skilled Worker and using Express Entry, it does not apply to a lot of people. It is very sharp on a specific people. I came with a similar program. I was only 24 years old. I was speaking English perfectly. And I had a degree and I had work experience. But how many people are having that? There is not very many. However, there is other programs as well. So beside the Federal Skilled Worker or federal programs, there is also provincial programs. And the provincial programs are essentially different because Federal Skilled Worker is basically skill-based immigration. Canada wants you because you're skilled, but provincial nominee programs are need-based programs. We want you here because we need you, not because you acquire some skills. One of the very specific programs in the province of BC is something that we know it as Tech Pilot. It used to be a tech program. It used to be a pilot program. And pilot program is just something that we test. For 4 years, it was a test program, like 2018, 19, 20, and 21. It was pilot. Like we were trying to test it to see if it works. And it was so good that it became a permanent program. This immigration program is amazing. If you have studied or acquired knowledge in one of the categories that they say, mostly tech and engineering, they actually tell you, in one of my students' experience, in 27 minutes, they responded to someone and they're like, apply, you're qualified for it. It doesn't mean that they get the PR in 27 minutes. It means that they receive the answer that they are a qualified thing in 27 minutes. They have like a fast concierge that they evaluate you And they just provide you with the documents that you need. And within 6 to 8 months, you become a PR if you ever want to be a PR. So what do you need? You need to have studied tech, okay? You need to have had some background in it. And also you need to have a job offer. But this job offer is not like the job offer that you have to get for labor market impact assessment. This is an LMIA exempt job offer. As long as somebody tells to the government that I am hiring this person, it's okay. It's just as easy as a letter. They don't have to go through exhaustive process to prove to the government that they need you. So the tech pilot's job offer is LMIA exempt, very easy. Now, here it is when the school comes in. There is a program out there which says if you study tech and if you have a job offer, you're more likely to stay in Canada. If your English is good, you know, like all the immigrant requirements that everything else has, if you are actually studying tech and you have a job offer, then you can stay in Canada. So how does our school help you in that? Well, number one, I have to train you within 1 year because this is our philosophy. You come to us as a blank person. We want to give a computer expert in 1 year. That's our philosophy. And we're working, we're razor sharp focused on that. So what we do is that first we go and buy government data of what is the labor market in the next 10 to 15 years. So we get this data, I just pay for it, I buy it. Then our data scientists, including myself, Jamek, and a whole bunch of other teams, we'll look into it and we're cross-referencing two different lists. List number one, what is needed in the next 15 years? List number two, which salary keeps getting higher in the next 10 to 15 years? We cross-reference these two. Voila, this is the programs that we offer. We offer you the programs that we know there is jobs for them. We are absolutely 100% sure by the time that you graduate, which is only a year from now, there is a still market for it. Okay? So then I, as the senior academic administrator or senior educational administrator, I sit down and I'm like, okay, I know that we need web developers. And like, you know, we need computer architects. We need this and this in the next few years. So how can I create one of this? All right, then I need to create a program that, imagine that I want to create a web architect. And I'm like, oh, in order to be a web architect, you need to know some tools. You need to know JavaScript. You need to know Node.js. You need to know PHP. You need to know Laravel. You need to know Ruby. You need to know Perl. You need to know Python. You know, all the other tools that you need to know, Java, stuff like that. So I package all of this together and then I call it open source web development because these are all open source products and they are hot. All of our students that we had, we actually introduced open source web development about 4 years ago. And I can guarantee you, most of our students, they were hired before graduation. We had a very sweet problem. The problem was that they would get a job before they graduate. Mostly in other colleges, they get a job, they just study, they graduate, and then they struggle. Everybody says, we help you. But, you know, eventually they dissipate or they get an unrelated job, whatever. But for us, it was completely different. We had the problem in the other way. We had to come up innovatively to let people finish their studies. I actually had two Brazilians that they just got a job offer before even they were graduated. That's like one program. We have another program, which is called embedded programming. That is basically mostly focused on C++ and the tools that you can program chips. We have another program, which is called graphic and web development, which is specifically geared toward web programming using Microsoft products. We have another one, which is called network administration. This is specifically geared toward designing and maintaining network. Technically speaking, we have 19 different diplomas, 7 or 8 of them directly focuses on IT. The rest of them, because we're a technology college, we're really one of a kind. Like there is only 4 or 5 other colleges that they do something similar that we do in entire BC. And I don't really think that any one of them does anything similar to us. So what we do is that we don't really have a competitor. We're doing this stuff the way that we do, and we've been doing it really well. And the reason is just the scientific approach that we have. We actually go and ask what is needed, then we create a package, and then we just deliver it to people. As a result, every other program that we have, including business, interior design, whatever, they're also very much computer-related and tech-related. So everybody knows as a tech, like probably we're the most famous private tech in BC, if not in Canada. All right. So having said that, I would just like to give it back to Jean-Marc to kind of like talk about the individual situation that we had, the students that we had. Like I told you about a few students that we had. We have extremely successful students, some of them, including Jean-Marc. But, you know, I'm not talking about Jean-Marc graduated 20 years ago. I'm talking about recent graduates as well. There is not a day that I walk by for a few blocks from the office that people don't come around, hug me, and they're telling me, Sohail, you changed our lives. So back to Jean-Marc to continue.
Actually, I think we're out of time. Luca, are there any questions?
Yeah, we also have some questions, if it's fine.
Let's do that. That's more beneficial.
Okay, so the first one is from Carlos. He asked, about, I think he's referring to the period of 1 year that you guys said it would be enough for a computer student to be a junior at a tech company. He asked about how intensive is the education, and if there is like free time, like in the matter of having free time to do other things.
Carlos, I have good news and I have bad news for you. You're not gonna get to play much. That 1 year, think of it as you're going into military. That 1 year is gonna change your life forever, right? You come in, you're gonna work hard. This isn't easy, right? I mean, you have to imagine trying to compact everything into that 1 year. It's a lot of work. So you get about 20 hours a week of class time. I would say you have to put at least 20 to another 20, 25 hours, maybe 30 hours of work yourself. But yeah, you know, you have your weekends to work 20 hours a week, and then you have some of the evenings and stuff to go out and recuperate and rejuvenate as well. But I would say, yes, expect to have to work hard during that 1 year.
Okay, perfect. And the other question is about the pandemic and how things are rolling in Canada, and if there's any perspective of anytime soon students going back to BC. And
okay, so Hel, you want to take that?
Sure. Yeah, we've been actually, we have had a very conservative approach. Just like looking at numbers and everything, we're just one of the last ones that we would like to introduce. One thing that we know is that we're always going to have a hybrid model, but it's definite that in January we're opening the school. Like we just decided, we have all the artifacts, all the numbers from the government is fine. A lot of people are vaccinated. If you're fully vaccinated and you come to Canada, and even if the vaccines are not the government of Canada approves, you just do 14 days quarantine, and then we check your documents, and then you're coming in. We won't let people not vaccinated in. But if they're fully vaccinated, class is just business as usual, or a new usual, which is going to be hybrid. We will not have 100% in class anyways, but it's going to be hybrid student life / online. So that will start in January.
Okay, perfect. Good news then. We also have another one. Marina is asking about the percentage of international and local students in ITD.
It fluctuates. We have students from all over the place. Before pandemic, the ratio was like 70% international, 30% local. Right now, it's like a year and a half that we didn't really have a supply of international students. Instead, we had a good supply of local students. So like right now, the population is about 300 students, and over 200 of them are local, and only 100 are international. So right now we have more local students than international. It just fluctuates based on the thing. But I would say our goal is to keep it 50-50. But it never happens. It doesn't, we can't align it like that. So there is like a little bit more in international, a little bit more sometimes in local. At the moment, we have more local students than international.
Okay, perfect. I think that answers the question. Thank you, Sohail and Jean-Marc. It was really, really informative. I personally really liked it. I didn't know about all the opportunities of a tech professional in Canada. And yeah, it was really, really good. Thank you for your time.
Awesome.
A pleasure. No Luca, just to close this, there are partial scholarships available, but we're not going to announce them. If anybody is interested, send us a message on chat, go to our booth, send us a message on chat, and we'll evaluate it individually rather than trying to make it. And that's also a reason for you guys to connect with us. So make sure you send a chat message if you're interested in tech at all. Thanks, everybody. Have a great rest of the afternoon.
Yeah, you too. Thank you.